Good morning, YouTube. Finally got our replacement bearings in. Took 2 days for overnight shipping, so yeah, these days you just can't count on anything showing up on time, but luckily we got them in. They're the right size. I went with the shielded bearings, which is what Grizzly shows for their current part number. So what I have is I put the splitter here. I want to support the inner race while I press this in, so that I've got the splitter scrunched up as far as I can. Okay, that's bottomed out on the flat there. Yeah, so there we go. The spacer needs to go on next, and you have to put the groove at the top. And I also put a little red felt pin in there so I could see that through the set screw hole. I don't know if that'll help at all. Okay, I had to lower the deck on the press a little bit, and I have my pressing tool here. I just drilled an 11/16 hole through the middle of a block of UHMW that I had, so that should hit the inner race there. There we go. There's just a piece of scrap that I had left over, and it was the right length to fit over the end of the shaft. Okay, so I've got the gearbox here, and I don't think the alignment on these is terribly critical, but what I did was try to find the center of the worm. So I've got that marked here with that black mark, and then I found the center of the bearing race there roughly, and have that silver mark there. So you can see that whole thing just drops through here. It's also applied a little bit of oil inside the cast iron. Yeah, there we go. It should be sticking through. There we go. And I just want to go until the bearing is down in the housing there. Oh yeah, it goes in real easy. Take a look at that. Yeah, there we go. There's my center mark on the worm and the center mark on the bore there. And this time the bearing is all the way in there. I don't know if that shows up there, but I can see my red mark inside on the spacer, so I know that's in the groove there. So let's put the screw in. So this was a M8 set screw. I just happen to have one here that's, I think, the right length. Probably a little bit longer than it needs to be, but that's what I had. I think this was a 20. I imagine the old one was about a 16. Okay, and then here we have the worm gear and shaft. One thing I did was I chucked this up in my lathe and polished this end, because it was kind of messed up from the old broken drive wheel. So I got that polished down. I also beveled the end here beyond the snap ring. Hopefully it'll make taking it apart easier next time. Yeah, put a little oil on the parts there. Oh yeah, I mean that just fits right in there now. Let's see, there should be a snap ring groove. I showed you the spacer that was under that gear. So that's in there. I think that's there. There's the snap ring groove, and then the drive wheel goes over there. Okay, YouTube, so there is a snap ring that goes on top of the upper bearing and on top of the shaft. And I guess when I pressed everything together, the shaft was down a little bit farther because I was pressing against the bearing. So anyway, what I found worked was I needed to push the shaft back this way. So I got my pry bar in there with a block of metal behind it so I could put some pressure on here. And I pushed until the shaft popped out of the end. And then also the bearing kind of popped out a little bit too. What I did was I put my pressing block on there and popped the bearing in until the snap ring groove was exposed, and then I got the snap ring on. What I've done is I pushed the shoulder up into the bottom bearing, and then I pushed the top bearing down, and then I guess the snap ring holds the two bearings together so that there's no way the shaft can move in or out, or up or down, whichever direction you're looking at. Pretty tight fit in there. Ah, there we go. That's more like it. So I did measure the protrusion of the shaft before, but since the thing was pushed out, I don't know if that measurement is actually any good. Got the pulley lined up. Well, number one, you can't really line the pulley up until you tension the belt, because the motor kind of tips when it's loose. So what I did is I got the pulley pretty close and then put up the tensions, and then just sighted up the pulley, you know, from this direction and then also down that way, just to make sure it was running straight. So I just plugged in power temporarily here, and watch this. Wow. Totally silent. That is nice. Yeah, before I was just making crunching, grinding sounds. It sounded like something was getting ready to blow up. Problem is, if that lower bearing had gone out, that would probably destroy the shaft. Worm and the worm gear would get chewed up. So yeah, good thing I caught that. It was just getting too loud, and it was getting worse progressively. So I think I have it assembled right now. I think this was probably just assembled wrong at the factory, because I've never touched this gearbox other than add oil to it. But I've never had the pulley off, I've never had the bearings apart, and that upper bearing had worked its way up. I just don't think it was ever installed right in the first place. I don't think the worm shaft was pushed in all the way, and then the upper bearing wasn't seated in the casting, and then that just led to it getting loose, and then that meant the bottom bearing was doing all the work, and then it gradually wore out. Okay, there we go. YouTube, got the gearbox filled up, belt cover put in place, and listen to this. Wow. Really happy with that. So yeah, we got a whole new drive end here, rebuilt gearbox, then the new drive wheel on there, and got the oil changed, sucked out all the old oil, cleaned out all the sludge in the gearbox. That's one thing I never did at the beginning, which I probably should have. I hear there's often a lot of grit from the casting process left in the box, and then they pour the oil in and you end up with basically grinding paste in there. So I remember I drained the old oil out and I put new oil in, but I don't think I ever cleaned the inside of the box out. And you can't really clean it out until you pull everything out of there anyway. Lots of nooks and crannies underneath all the gears, so I know I never cleaned it out. If you have noise coming out of your gearbox, probably a good idea to take it apart and figure out what's wrong. In my case, it was a $10 bearing was going. I replaced both of them just because I was there. So $20 repair, and this will probably be good for quite a while until that gear wears out, and then I'll replace that when I get there. So yeah, hope you enjoyed that repair. If you found it helpful, give the video a thumbs up, and as always, thanks for watching.